other men.
Oh, interesting.
Oh.
You know, so that's how...
We heard somebody's been saying they want the weaves out.
Right. Oh, yeah. When, once they get booed up, and once they, like, they get booed up or they married, they're like, okay, you got to take that out now. You know, because... You know, that's how they was attracted to them. They didn't want nobody else to be attracted to them also.
We also heard some of the younger men saying that more natural hair seemed to be coming, more the direction things were going.
Well, yeah, I promote natural hair for my clients. You know, I always try, because a lot of black women don't even know what their natural hair look like. Because that's just like a lot of women were saying, they begin to relax since they was five. You know, so from five to you 35, you never even seen a natural, every 4 to 6 weeks, that's forever, you know?
I haven't seen my own hair since I was maybe 20. Mm-hmm. Before I put, you know, I had put it away for so long. But I noticed that in Atlanta, there seems to be a big push towards natural hair. There seems to be really accepted.
Well, I don't know. You must be in the West End somewhere, honey, because where I'm at, they are not,
your hairstylist, you could make it ruly.
Well, that is. But see, when you say, when you get a relaxer, it's different ways we use a relaxer. People just get relaxed and make their hair straight. First of all, that's the wrong way to do a relaxer. You're not supposed to get your hair bone straight anyway. Relaxer is just a texturizer. Mm-hmm. What it does, it kind of just breaks it down. You know, we just leave it on so long to make it fall straight. But if somebody has really kinky, textured hair, you can take a relaxer, comb it through for 3 seconds, rinse it out, and you still have your still curly texture of hair. It doesn't have to be straight.
No. That makes me sad.
Well, why?
It makes me sad for you to say that there are some women who need the relaxer. If somebody wants to be natural and wants to wear their natural texture,
it's like him looking at me and going, dude, long hair is not for you.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
It's just not. You know, I don't care long hair. It's just not my thing. But listen, mm-hmm. I knew you were going towards natural, but I understand you brought us fantasy.
I did bring fantasy.
Tell us about that.
Well, fantasy hair is just avant-garde, high-end, just hair. It's wearable art.
Wearable.
What it is. Wearable art.
And let's see the models. What do you got?
Well, come on out, darling. Well, for her, what we did was we did a whole dress made out of hair. It's bantu knots in the top.
Wow.
And then we just used some wavy hair towards the bottom left as its natural texture. And for the mohawk section, it's actually two ponytail pieces put together to create this mohawk look. And then we did a braid around the side, and we sprayed the sides gold, did some braids on the side. So.
Desalina, isn't that itchy?
We'll jack you up for that dress. I really will.
Okay, our next model is Lisa. Lisa, why don't you come on out? Look at this. This is more hair,
more hair, yes.
Oh, my God.
So, Lisa has, I did a gown out of hair also. This is about 30 packs of hair. For the hair portion of it, we just went to Michael's and got some styrofoam balls and kind of covered the hair with styrofoam balls and just kind of placed them in there to give it a more artsy, abstract look for the hair.
And the hair dress.
It looks a little Planet of the Apes.
When somebody says hairdresser, now I'm going to think of this.
Yeah,
there you go.
You are.
Well, thank you, Derek. I appreciate it. A lot of fun. And ladies, thank you so much. And when we come back, we're going to see how Nakisha and Tiamat's makeover with Felicia Leatherwood has gone. We'll be right back. Clear that she and her daughter Tiamat needed help with their coarse hair. Felicia Leatherwood has been working on them backstage. Now, here is what Nakisha looked like before. And let's see how she looks now. Coming out, Nakisha and Tiamat. Lovely. Nakisha, how does it feel to you?
I like it.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I like it. I like it.
What'd she do?
She cut it. It was actually maybe the color of Kim's hair. And it was like in a fro. And she trimmed it. And she massaged my scalp.
Well, Felicia's actually down here. Tell us what you did do and what the... Yeah, she's happy.
So what we did... Basically, she had a little bit about stress and diet, mm-hmm. and water, and how it plays a part in hair and hair growth. So I cut her hair. We gave her a trim. We brought it up so you could see her cheekbones and how beautiful her face is. And I used a little bit of some hair rules, mm-hmm. curly whip on her, and some Shea Moisture Hold and Shine product. And then with her beautiful daughter, she got a little bit of icy spray, a little oil sheen spray, but her hair was already beautiful.
Yeah,
she is. And that's what we did.
See, am I too happy with what she did?
Yeah.
So, are you going to start wearing your hair more natural now, or?
I wear it natural a lot, but the thing is with the twist out where people, like Kim's hair is, mm-hmm. I have to twist it at night, and I say maybe on a Sunday. By Tuesday, I have to twist it again, which takes people, like Kim's hair is. Mm-hmm. I have to twist it at night, and I say maybe on a Sunday. By Tuesday, I have to twist it again, which takes the length of Love Jones. You ever seen that movie? I start at the beginning, and then about time, you know, at the end of the movie when it's raining, I'm done. So that's like 2 hours. You know, I have to do it like every 2 days. So I'm like, it's just not worth it. I usually leave it braided. With this, it was quick, convenient, can brush and pretty much go. And she gave me a list of stuff to use in it, so it's going to be a breeze now.
Mm-hmm. There's something really attractive about it. Yeah, of course. It really does remind me of your hair.
I love it.
Ladies, thank you so much. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Hair.